You're looking at the first partial lunar eclipse of 2012. Watch as the moon toe dips, if you will, into the Earth's shadow, as if someone's taking a bite out of our nearest planet's nearest neighbor. The eclipse veiled 37% of the moon's surface. Officials at NASA confirm it began at 3 a.m. along the West Coast, peaking at after 4 a.m. and then ending at 5:06, which would be just after 8 our time on the East Coast. If you're wondering why you didn't catch the glimpse, it's because the moon had already set at a time in mid-Atlantic and Northeast, so it wasn't visible from our windows.
Aw.
Why didn't they tell us before?
Too bad.
Okay, whatever.
It's too bad.
Well, but there is one rare astronomical event you will be able to catch tomorrow, and it's likely your only shot ever to do it.
It's called the Transit of Venus, and it's supposed to be pretty spectacular. 11 News reporter Kim Dacey has the details.
Astronomers are calling it a once-in-a-lifetime event, the Transit of Venus.
Transit of Venus is simply the moving of Venus in front of the sun as we see it from the Earth. It's almost like an eclipse. If you think of an eclipse where the moon passes in front of the sun, same thing going on here, except Venus is much, much farther away than the moon, so it looks very small.
The transit will only be visible in Maryland between 6 and 8 p.m. Tuesday evening. The Maryland Science Center will be holding a free event open to the public to watch the transit from their observatory telescope and their roof, as well as other events starting at 5.
We have a speaker from NASA Goddard Space Flight Center, Keith Strong, who will be talking about the eclipse. We have a planetarium program at 5. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 telescopes set up with solar filters. We have a couple of other viewing devices as well. And we'll have activities in our meeting room next door so people can sort of get involved in activities to understand what the transit is about a little bit better.
Astronomers warn not to look directly at the sun during the transit. You need to use something to protect your eyes, like eclipse glasses or a welder's mask.
But the thing is not to look at the sun directly. Don't look at the sun through things like, you know, film or sunglasses or digital media. Sometimes people think that's safe, but it's not. You really have to have very thick glasses, and that takes out all the dangerous rays of the sun. Just let you see the sun disk and Venus moving across it.
The transit only happens every 105 years in pairs 8 years apart. The last time was in 2004, so the next time the transit of Venus will be visible from Earth is in 2117. So Tuesday is your only chance to see this phenomenon.
We're all going around the sun, and every so often you get one of these interesting alignments where you see something that is really rare. So that's the reason to see it.
For more information on the transit or the Science Center event, you can find a link on our website, WBALTV.com. At the Science Center, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.